role of homeopathy in acute situation, simply it is amazing if we able to take the proper rubric in proper time. During acute situation, most of the time the patient shows symptoms either in mental plane or in physical plane of its own, but we have to know how to collect the symptoms, and with an analytical mind, with knowledge of materia medica, how we can help or even get greater result in comparison with other system of medicine. I am giving some examples. Very recently we are treating a case of dengue. The child was suffering from high rise of temperature, body ache, nausea, vomiting, and the drastically platelets is falling. And we know virtually there is no treatment of dengue except the analgesics or the antipyretics and some maintenance of the body fluid. The peculiarity in this case, what we observe, that last 3 days child always telling, please put up the light. And day and night the child is rather residing in a dark room. Then I asked, what happens if lights are putting on? Then the child is, I can't tolerate it. It hurts my eyes. I get extreme pain, unbearable pain if lights are there. I can't tolerate. My eyes are hurting. Simply on that ground, and we ask, but anything? Yes, during night the child is sweating a lot. So night sweating or sweats during sleep, and this photophobia without redness, that is photophobia without conjunctivitis. On this two rubric we have taken, and we prescribe conium maculatum, and the result was amazing. The falling tendency of the platelets stop. Within 2 days platelets improves, fever subsided, body ache subsided, and only with this conium, this dengue markers become negative within 4 days. So the question, not the disease or what you are treating, rather selection of the medicine which will help us in acute situation. So more we know this type of selection in acute conditions, I think we can do a better way through the understanding of materia medica and the application of repertory. And the next case, in acute situation most of the time, especially we miserably fail in some types of cough. The child is coughing, vomiting throughout the night. Sometimes child is coming, coughing, child gets irritable. But remember that most probably one of the neglected remedy for the children's cough or even cough of the adults, the medicine we rarely used in cough is mesalium. If after taking proper cases very nicely, either observing or asking the question, if we get the symptoms that cough better after vomiting, there is no cough. In belladonna, in corallium rubrum, in drosera, in mephitis, child's cough, vomits, and this paroxysmal cough, it is coming after vomiting after a while. But in case of mesalium, what we get, that after this vomiting, child sleeps very nicely, or mother is telling, or the patient's associates are telling that my child is all right after vomiting. After vomiting, child sleeps very nicely and comfortably, and a single dose of mesalium will do the amazing result. And think mesalium in this type of process, who is really very few homeopaths are using in cough. So this is the rubric. Rubric selection is more important than what type of books you are taking, because some rubrics are in some rubrics in other books, but mostly what rubric you are selecting, that is most important than what book or the repertory book are using. So this type of unusual, uncommon symptoms at that present moment, which is qualifying the patient's individualistic feature, that is most important. Say for example that generally when a patient is coughing with rawness, soreness, dry cough, mostly unproductive cough, and patient is telling it hurts my throat, generally when the second question, how you get rid of this type of cough, and if patient is telling I get rid of cough if I drink water. Now, is it not amazing or unusual that during cough patient is taking some sorts of cold water? Now we have to differentiate regarding this cold water amyloidosis. The first medicine generally we think with rawness and soreness is causticum, and sometimes with the spurting of urine due to this spasmodic cough, causticum, it does a lot. But remember that in this type of a spasmodic cough, another medicine is very important, that is cupra metallica, because cupra, it is known for its spasmodic affection, recurrent bouts of coughing, then again for a while a rest, then again coughing, and patient used to get rid of that symptom after drinking cold water. The simple, only on this cold water, so many masters have prescribed causticum or cupra-metallicum. But we have another two medicine, very important medicine. When cough is not dry cough, but it is loose cough, remember, lot of expectoration is coming, lots, bouts of cough, coughing, and lots of expectoration. And what is the modality? Time modality is the morning, just after rising, the patient coughs more and more, coughing, and the peculiarity of cough, just you look, the expectoration is just like ropey expectoration, it is hanging from the mouth. So what we are getting? Spasmodic cough of cupram metallicum, morning aggravation of lachesis, and ropey elastic discharge of the chelicerone. And here also patient is getting better by drinking cold water. So if these combined pictures we are getting, the only medicine you will get in our Kent repertory, that is our Coccus cacti, loose cough, paroxysmal cough, better by drinking cold water. So every time we are guided by a symptom complex, and this symptom complex, more we read Materia Medica, more we gone through the repertory, this type of peculiar indication of the most of the polycrest or a smaller medicine you will get. Now another cough medicine, what I am telling in acute condition, it will give a very good result when patient is getting better by drinking cold water with cough, but here is no vomiting, but cough better by drinking cold water. But there is another peculiar concomitant, that is flatulence and dyspepsia, gastric irritation, acidity, heartburn, and patient is complaining. With that we are getting a cough, and I am compelled to take water during coughing. Remember, this is one of the indigenous medicine, but we can do rather a magic in some sorts of cough, especially when multi-organ involvement, especially in case of cancer, most of the breast cancer ultimately leads to the metastasis to the lungs, or even after chemotherapy, that GI involvement. And this type of GI involvement, lung involvement with this type of unproductive cup, better by drinking cold water, think of Sosuriya Lappa. This Sosuriya Lappa, try it when patient is telling that my cough is complicated with gastric problem. So every time we are guided by a symptom complex. Now, one of the very small medicine or big medicine, or every day we are using that medicine, but we are not giving lot of importance that that medicine can be applied as also a cancer, a cough remedy. Suppose you are getting a patient that spasmodic cough, it starts after the midnight. As soon as midnight, then we are thinking most probably we have to give arsenic album or hypersulfur or arsenic compound. But patient is telling very nicely, doctor, I can't lie on my back. If I lie on back, this spasmodic cough develops. Then what you do? I am compelled to lie on left side or right side. Is it? Then how long this cough persists? My cough persists till I awake. Take the rubric, paroxysmal cough, midnight onwards till awaking. Aggravation, lying on back, better by lying on sideways. Simply ask whether patient is chilly or not. Patient is chilly. And most probably, not most probably, the only medicine will be covered by Nux Vomica from Kent's repertory. And in my opinion, Nux is one of the neglected medicine in respiratory distress. So this type of beautiful tips, so-called tips, we will get more we apply the repertory. This another peculiar application, what at least I am applying a medicine, very small medicine, but giving immense result, especially when all medicine fails, only based on observation or the patient is telling a peculiar amelioration. What type of amelioration, doctor? You are observing, or even in clinic you are observing, or patient is telling that my respiration is arrested. I can't breathe properly. SOB, shortness of breath, whatever it is. So, arrested breathing, difficult breathing. And what you do? That whenever this type of respiration difficulty occurs, I am compelled to lie on left side. Respiration difficult, better lying on left side. Still I remember one of my case when I was a residency of National Institute of Homeopathy, that a lady was admitted in our hospital with thyroid complication. Still I remember. But during midnight, what you are observing, that dyspnea, severe dyspnea, breathing difficulties, and patient is always lying on the left side when she is talking or answering our questions. And instantly we prescribe Castoreum. We should go through the Kent's repertory, respiration difficult or arrested, and then you will get better by lying on left side. The single medicine in Kent's repertory is Castoreum. And we prescribe the medicine, and I think within 15 minutes that dyspnea subsided. And in this type of acute condition, more you get this type of peculiar modality after the rubric hunting from different books, more you will be confident and patient will be happy, and we also explore the utility of the homeopathic application in acute conditions and how quickly it can act. Until and unless you see by your own work and your own result, even you will not able to believe that it happens through homeopathic medicine. Then another case, especially this rubric, I told that photophobia of corneum maculatum. Now observe a patient, especially old patients, that patient is complaining, doctor, I cannot lie down. What happens? If I lie down, my cough aggravates. I cannot lie, I can't touch my head on the pillow, because as soon as lie down, my head touches the pillow, it cough, it coughing, coughing, coughing. In this condition, generally we homeopaths, we prescribe hyoscyamus, one of the medicine, croton teak, another medicine. In case of croton teak, generally the patient will narrate another concomitant symptom, that is loose stool, forcible loose stool, and patient is sitting that throughout the night I am compelled to sit, I can't touch, I can't lie down. So that is the croton teak. And in case of hyoscyamus, throughout the night, as soon as touches the pillow, the head touches the pillow, cough aggravates, but it is unproductive dry cough with other concomitants, as you know, that especially the exhibitionism and other things, you have to take a little bit mental symptoms of the hyoscyamus from patient's behavior.